Welcome to part 3 of the Dying Light Developer Tools Guide. In the previous video, we showed you the basic toolbar icons. In this video, we'll discuss tools that let you move objects on the map. The most essential tool is the Select Object tool. You can find its icon on the toolbar or simply press the S key on your keyboard. If you want to select a number of objects, press and hold the Control key while selecting. After selecting one or more objects, you can easily center the camera on your selection by pressing F on your keyboard. To move any object, click the Move Object toolbar icon or press W on your keyboard. Objects can be moved by using the red, green, and blue arrows displayed on the screen. The colors correspond with the X, Y, and Z axes respectively, while these arrows are referred to as the gizmo of an object. The gizmo is displayed in the pivot of the objects that is the center of the object's local coordinate system. If you have trouble remembering the colors of the axis, identify them with the RGB mode. The X axis is R, or red, the Y axis is G, or green, and the Z-axis is B, or blue. Click on the colored squares around the object to move it along two axes at the same time. The majority of available objects also have so-called hooks, which makes snapping objects together much easier. You can see how it works when you move an object along the street. This option is called a hook snap, and it can be disabled using the 4 key on your keyboard if you want. Finally, you can press and hold the Shift key to clone objects. And by pressing A on the keyboard and clicking the left mouse button on the map, you can easily move a selected object. Combine this with the Shift to clone and place objects very quickly. And that's it for part 3. In the next video, we'll talk about rotating objects. Thanks for watching.